How President Trump is seen in Mexico and arms trade issues is framed by how he is seen in general, which is someone who is very hostile to Mexico in general, and also very militarist in his approach to policy issues in general. So there's a lot of distrust. There's a lot of fear, both in Mexico and in the Mexican diaspora, around what he will do, particularly with immigrants, but also in the overall relationship. He's unstable. He is a little unpredictable, and he can be nasty. So the other thing that I think some people are aware of, though not as many in Mexico, is his relationship with the arms industry. So his embrace of the NRA, his embrace of gun producers, is also something that shapes the way he's approaching things. He has said that the illegal gun traffic from the United States into Mexico is a problem that should be addressed, but that's gotten very little attention. What's gotten much more attention is that when he spoke with Enrique Peña Nieto in his first week in office, he reportedly said, well, you all have some bad hombres there and we can send some troops to take care of it. So that also frames how people understand what his approach is to arms, which is perhaps not just arming Mexican forces, but also potentially even sending U.S. armed personnel. All trend over the last several years of growth in both small arms, firearms, as well as military equipment. So this began, really it began in 2008, but then it accelerated when Enrique Peña Nieto came into office in 2012. There were a number of very large sales, and you can see also a growth in firearm sales. So there's not much measurement yet in terms of what kinds of, there's been no, for example, announced deals of military transfers in the first 100 days in office. But we're also waiting for the measurement of U.S. assistance that Trump included in one of his first executive orders. Now, that measurement could be a way to say, we're not going to give as much assistance as we did before. Or it could be a way to say, we want to give more in order to fight the drug war, because certainly the other pieces of Trump's policy include accelerating the military approach to drug policy in Mexico as elsewhere. So some of that might be through sales and some of it might be through assistance. It's not yet clear. The one other thing I would say about end-use controls is that over the last 4 years, firearms, if we're going to count firearms, munitions, parts, and bombs and grenades that were transferred legally to Mexico, they're about $208 million worth. Now, more than half of those left through the port of Laredo, Texas, which means that they entered into Mexico in the state of Tamaulipas. Tamaulipas is controlled by the Zetas cartel, the Zetas drug cartel. So we have a very serious end-use control problem there, because whatever kind of filtration of firearms between the armed forces and organized crime in Mexico may be occurring throughout the country in little ways, when you have bulk shipments coming in of firearms into a state that is controlled by organized crime, there's a very serious vulnerability of diversion at that point. So that's something that is not known and has certainly not been investigated and should be. Well, I think that the Democrats and others who care about the impact of firearms in Mexico and in general, the instability that is caused by violent conflict in Mexico, and they should be caring about it, because it is making migrants flee more towards the United States. I mean, this is part of the central cause of migrants coming to the United States, which is at the center of so much U.S. policy. So they should be caring about the results of these kinds of both legal and illegal firearms transfers from the United States to Mexico. So they really need just to pay more attention. That means asking more questions about end-use controls. What are some of the State Department's Blue Lantern inspections? Why have a third of them come up unfavorable for Mexico? Who are the actual end users of firearms that are legally transferred to Mexico? Because firearms are controlled and distributed by the Mexican Army for use by all police forces within Mexico. That includes federal police, state police, and local police, who are notoriously corrupt. So the records that the congressional offices are getting now are very vague on this matter. And so there needs to be much more vigorous inquiry of both the State Department and the Defense Department in order to ensure that firearms are not getting to corrupt forces, abusive forces, and to organized crime.